Let me start this video out by saying I fully expect to get some hate mail for this, especially from featherweight purists. But I've avoided certain subjects in the past, which I'm not going to avoid anymore. And the subject of featherweight light rewiring, that's the one for this time. Featherweights use cloth wire in a lead sheath, and we've all seen what happens. The lead sheath develops lead oxide all over the outside of it, that white flaky stuff, it gets falls off inside the machine, gets all over your gears, makes a mess. Well, what we're going to do today, we're going to rewire that light socket, we're going to do it using modern materials, and we're going to make it so that, like the lead, when you bend it, it stays put, so it'll avoid the gears. Now, going into this, I didn't mention it in the video itself, but I'll mention it in the introduction. If you've got a 201-2 with that nasty, nasty, almost asphalt-like sheathing that they use to protect it, you can use this same technique that I'm about to show you to replace that nasty, disgusting, asphalt-like sheathing in a 201-2's light socket. So hang tight, and we'll show you how I made this work. Before we get going, just so you know, this is not my machine. This one belongs to a customer. I discussed this modification with the customer this morning. She's all for it. She likes the idea of getting the lead out of her machine as well. Her machine was made in 1937. It probably had some of the worst lead oxide problems I've ever seen in a machine. You'll notice in this that I am not wearing gloves when I'm working on it. That is my bad. After I got the lead out of there, I went and I washed the crap out of my hands. So, yeah, wear gloves, wear a mask, don't be like me, I'm an idiot. God, this is disgusting. All right, we're gonna take the wires, which are thoroughly encrusted with schmoo. We're gonna take this completely out of the machine. I'm gonna start off, well, I've already removed the screw up there at the light. I'm gonna take the screw that holds the power block out. There we go. And having extracted that, there's a screw on this wire clamp. Remove that. So we'll take that and the clamp off. And that's half inch. Do I have a 9/16 handy? Where's my 9/16? Here's my 9/16. From the top, take off the little plastic one, and then is that 9/16? Yeah, it's 9/16. We loosen that. Now, I just got off the phone with the owner of this machine. I explained to her what I'm going to be doing, and she was fine with it. So, before anybody starts saying, oh, you're destroying the authenticity of a Featherweight, the owner's cool with it. It's her machine. She likes the idea. And that's what we're going to do. So, just loosen the nuts here a little bit with the tool. Okay, it's coming loose. There we go. We have to take off 1 and 3. 1 goes directly to the lamp. It's the only thing that's connected. 3, there's 2 conductors going there. 1 goes to the motor. 1 goes to the switch at the lamp. And there's a conductor, a single conductor on position 2, which goes, let me get these brass washers so I don't lose them. The single conductor on position 2 goes to the motor, and then I said the one that goes to the light switch, which is now freed up. I'm going to put the motor one back on and just cap it off for the moment with the brass washers and the nut off to the side. Lift this around. Extract. We're going to rewire the switch as well, because in the paper cover that goes over the switch. Okay. Why the hell did they do that? All right. We will extract. Oh, that screw is loose. Not good. This, kids, is crud. That's lead oxide that is coming off this sheath. Now, you may say that that's not a big deal as far as the toxicity of that amount of lead, but it's a big deal when that crap gets down and gets into your gears. So, yeah, this is going to be a bit of a mess to clean up. Now I'm going to extract the light out through the body of the machine. And you can see that this lead oxide is just going to be peeling off all over. Yeah, it made a mess all over the place. Shake that down. Let me grab a brush. Start cleaning that off. Brushing this out of the machine itself for the moment. I've seen these things caked up pretty bad before. This is one of the worst ones. But then again, this machine hasn't been messed with for a long, long time. So God only knows how long it's been since it's been opened up. And obviously, it's never had the wiring messed with at all. I'm using a stainless steel brush to knock this crap off of here. It's all lead. And looking at the condition of these ring terminals, well, it's not looking very good. We're going to be putting new terminals. Well, we're going to be using new wire and new terminals. I'm going to show you a little trick that I've started doing. I think is an excellent substitute for this lead sheath. Slide that out. We're going to have to take that to the sink and clean that up. And Okay. Open up the back of the socket assembly. Here's the back. We're going to extract the wires, which sometimes it's easiest to push them out from the front. Push the conductor pins out from the front. These are pretty well jammed in there. All right. Come on out. Get out of there. There we go. Put the socket to the side. That'll have to be cleaned up. Drop this down here below the edge of the table and sweep all this crap onto my paper towel. This is not proper remediation for hazardous waste, kids. All right. You know what? This brush is beat. I'm going to throw it out. But there we go. I'm going to wash my hands. I'll be right back. All right. I've got my soldering station set up. We're going to take the conductors here off of this old wire. But first, while it's attached to a convenient handle, I'm going to use a rotary tool with a wire brush and clean those up. All right, that got most of it off. Now I'm going to take it to a buffer. I'm going to polish these real quick. The ends are polished, and that's the important part. Now my soldering station is heating up. I might have to heat it up beyond 365C. I'm going to just take... Nah, I don't need that just yet. I'm going to see if I can melt this old solder off of here and get the tip off. Sometimes some fresh solder helps the heat transfer to the old. There we go, there's one. I really like this ECG soldering station. I bought it recently because my old Unger soldering iron was starting to show its age. There we go, that's another. And while we're desoldering stuff, we're going to desolder the wire that's on this switch, because we're going to swap that out too. Come on. Actually, bump up the heat a bit. Another 10 degrees C. This thing heats up really, really fast. I bought it locally. Got a great price on it, too. This particular model, the JSSD2, I've seen them online anywhere from $90 to $110. This one I picked up locally for $80 at our local electronics store. I was really, really happy about getting that deal on it. All right. And... oh, that opened up nicely. Okay. Of course, it didn't do the vinyl any good, but oh well. And we'll use the solder sucker to get the rest of the residual extraneous solder off of that. I don't really like this desoldering tool, but it's what I've got at the moment. I don't do enough electronics to justify owning a pump or a powered desolderer, but this little thing will work. Now, I've already cut my wire, and I've cut it a little long. We're replacing this, so you see I've got way more than I need here, and that's fine. So
I'm going to start off by trimming just a little bit off this end of the end that's getting soldered to the conductors of the lamp socket. Notice this is one length of wire at this point. I don't bother to cut it just yet. So, this has been sitting here. The way to get these things lined up, and actually I trimmed that a little long. So I'm gonna go back and just that a little short. Okay. There's, you'll see, here, let me hold this up so you get a little closer. Grab something to point with. All right. You see, there's this piece here, this tab that sticks up. That actually winds up going up into the top end of the socket. So you want the wire coming up towards that. And you don't want to go, you don't want to be super generous with the solder on this. You kind of want to take a minimalist approach. Otherwise, if it gets too globby, you can't get wire back into the fixture. Or should say the terminal back into the fixture. So I'm putting a little bit on there. Alright, heating the work. There it goes, it's starting to flow now. Come on. There we go. Flowed through. Let it sit. Oh, Elizabeth brought me coffee. In my favorite mug, available on the website. Link is down in the description below. That's the first time I ever hawked anything on one of my YouTube videos. It's also t-shirts. And tote bags and all sorts of good stuff. And we're going to lather, rinse, repeat on the other side. Another chunk of this wire. Short chunk this time. But still longer than needed. I'm going to strip it back. Swing it around. Stick it through the hole. And solder that in place. The work heated up. Here we go. Coffee. It is Sunday morning, and the new Sunday morning quickies is out. And actually, it's almost Sunday afternoon. It's going on 11 o'clock. All right, now, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to put these conductors back into the plastic socket. Thusly. Okay. Now, I took this piece. This is 12 gauge Romex, basically. Or one strand from 12 gauge Romex. That, actually, this wasn't Romex. This was direct berry 12 gauge wire that I had. And I yanked out one conductor of it. I bent the ends over on each side, so it's approximately, it's a little bit longer, but approximately the same length as the original lead sheath, okay? So, here's what's going to happen. I'm putting this thing putting the socket back together again. Get the screws back in. Now, you know, that might have been an error. Let me try something here first. I'm not sure it's going to work. No, it's not. All right, I'm going to... My initial thought of bending the ends over was not correct, so I'm just going to cut those bent ends off. So it's just going to be a straight piece of wire. Insulated, but a straight piece of wire. I've got the original lead sheath here. I'm going to measure up. My wire is about the same length. It is the same length. Now I'm going to take a piece of 3/16 shrink tube, also cut to the same length. And this is how we're going to handle this. Set that aside. This is now... Okay. I'm going to put the shrink tube, the two 18 gauge conductors, down the shrink tube. Now, if you're using a different brand of 18 gauge wire to wire your light, you might need to go with a different size shrink tube. This particular wire that I'm using is very the insulation is rather thin, so this is working fine with 3/16. You might have to go 1/4 inch, and if you do, that's fine. Don't sweat that. Okay, so we get that in. Now what we've created here, we've created a monster. It's alive. Okay, so now we have both of our wires, our lamp wires, in with that piece of 12 gauge. Now, I'm going to be lazy and not go for my heat gun. I'm just going to use a microtorch. And I'm going to shrink this up. Ah, the wonders of modern thermoplastics. Okay, now that has shrunk much like the lead sheath. Now if we bend this, it's going to hold its shape, unlike these two wires, which if we bent it, it would be flopping in the breeze. So what we've created here, we have created a Frankenfurter. We have created a way to eliminate the lead sheath around these wires. We got rid of this crappy cloth insulated wire with modern thermoplastic insulated wire, and this goes all the way up to the socket. Likewise, we put the same type of wire rewiring the switch. You get rid of that little chunker there that's hanging, and next thing up is we'll put cut these to length. Once we know exactly where it's going to sit inside the machine, we'll give ourselves a little bit more meat than what Singer gave us. We'll put shrink tube and crimp connectors on, and that phase of rewiring this machine will be over. But anyway, that's what I wanted to show you for this portion of the video. I'm not going to go through the rest of this right now because I've got other things I'm doing on this machine. This is not my machine. This is a customer's machine. I did discuss this procedure with her this morning. She agreed wholeheartedly that this was a good option. She's a smart person. So, yeah, that's the deal. So, thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.